Hello future engineers, welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're still new to my channel and you like what I'm doing, please don't forget to subscribe and share my videos to your friends and to your friends' friends. That's the only way you can help me promote my channel and to keep me going, refreshed and inspired. And I'm very willing to share my knowledge, especially topics in civil engineering, for your benefit. So let's have the principle of superposition. So here we go. If the response of a structure is linear, which follows obeys Hooke's law, then the effect of several loads acting simultaneously can be obtained by superimposing or adding the effects of the individual loads. So, by experience, you have to derive the effect of a single load to a beam. Unfamiliar, the values of the slopes at the supports and the deflection under the load or at the center or whichever is being asked, or in general, using the previous methods by area moment or by double integration method. So this means that it requires geometric, by the way, geometric distortions to structure is negligible because the loadings are within Hooke's law. So if the structure will deform or it will be distorted, but negligible. And you need to familiar with deflection expressions for common loadings so that we can apply this superposition method. But because it has so many tables and we can only memorize some, especially if we derive it before, we derive the formulas before, so a table must be necessary in answering problems. So here's a list of tables for cantilever beams, deflection formulas for cantilever beams. This is the general expression for the deflection in terms of x from A, and in particular we derive this in other problems. So we have PL cube over 3EI for the vertical deflection downward, and theta b, the slope of the tangent at b, is pl square over 2ei. So you have to familiar with this deflection due to concentrated load. Then due to concentrated load, but it does not act at the free end, then this is the general expression for deflection, 0 less than equal to x less than equal to a, and this is for a less than equal to x less than equal to l. But I will not pressure you on memorizing this because supposedly you can derive this by making this as a problem, individual problem. So what is important are these expressions, delta B and theta B. However, it's also difficult to memorize these formulas, so it requires familiarization of common loadings, especially for this one. This is common. The first and next is common. This is also common, and this is also common. So just familiar with these deflections and slopes at the free end. So for this case, WOL to the fourth over 8EI, we derive this. And theta B is WL cube over 6EI. For a cantilever beam partially loaded with uniform load with length A, and this one is B, general expression for the deflection, then in particular at B, WOA cube over 24EI times 4L minus A, theta B, WOA cube over 6EI. So you will use this table in answering problems if a particular combination of loading falls any one of these situations. Then for this cantilever beam loaded with triangular loading with maximum intensity At the fixed support, this is the general expression for deflection. In particular, at B, you have to familiar with this. WL to the 4th over 30 EI. Then theta B is WL cube over 24 EI. So you have to familiar with this. This first, third, fourth, and fifth. These are important for you to familiar with. Then, cantilever beam loaded with couple MO. This is the general expression for deflection at any point X from A. Then this is the particular displacement at B, downward MOL square over 2 EI. Then theta B MOL over EI, which can be derived easily by area moment or slope deflection, conjugate beam method rather, but can also be derived by double integration. So we have another table for simply supported beams. I will not go over with this discussion anymore because this can be derived by double integration expression in general. And secondly, we will not usually use this, but rather this maximum deflection at center, PL cube over 48 EI. You have to familiar with this because I derived this in other methods. Theta A equals theta B by symmetry, PL square over 16 EI. So familiar with this too. But for this, I will not require you to familiar with this. You can always clip these formulas whenever they are required or needed in the problem. Then theta A, theta B. So I will not also explain this because you can always refer to this table whenever applicable in a particular problem. The next one, you need to familiar with this because I also derived this. It is for delta max, which is at the center or midspan, 5 WOL to the 4th over 34 EI, and theta equals theta B WOL cube over 24 EI. So familiar with this, the first one. Then, no need. General expressions for deflection. What is important is at the center, W over 384 EI, but you can have this because it's very difficult to memorize also these formulas. You just mention or copy this whenever they are required in a, these formulas are required in a particular problem. Then we have theta A and theta B values also. You are not obliged to memorize. Then for a simply supported beam loaded with triangular loading, general expression for deflection, you can derive that by double integration if you want. Then maximum deflection is 0.00652 WL to the 4th over EI. You are not also required to memorize that. And that happens at 0.5193 L unless you're required to derive all this. The center deflection is 0.006510 WL to the 4th over EI. You are not also required to memorize, but in order to derive this, you substitute here L over 2 for X so that you can derive this formula. Then theta A, theta B. You're not also required to memorize, but you can always refer to this whenever applicable in the problem. Then for this one, loaded with couple at one end, general expression for deflection. Then this is the maximum expression for deflection at X equals L over square root of 3. At the center, MOL square over 16 EI, then theta A equals theta A MOL over 6 EI, theta B MOL over 3 EI. So the relationship, the slope at B is greater than that at A, double that of theta A, but you are not required to memorize. Just those I mentioned, this, especially first and third. The rest, you can always refer to this table whenever applicable. So here is the first problem on superposition method. Find the midspan displacement of the simply supported beam using modulus of elasticity of 10 gigapascals and moment of inertia 20 times 10 to the 6 mm to the fourth. So remember, for mid-span deflection, I require you to memorize this loading, 5 WO L to the fourth over 84 EI. But for this one, we need to have a clip for a concentrated load and its deflection at mid-span or center. So it was by this formula, PB over 48 EI quantity 3 L square minus 4B square. 4b square if a is greater than b. This is a and this is b in the figure supposedly. But if you position yourself at the back, then this should be a and this should be b. So a is 4, b is 1, and we can apply this formula. Therefore, the mid-span deflection is equal to 5w l to the fourth over 84 ei, where w is 1 kilonewton per meter, plus PB over 48 EI quantity 3 L squared minus 4B squared, where L is 5 and B is 1. Substitute, so 5 times 1 times 5 to the 4th over 84 EI plus 2, B is 1 over 48 EI quantity 3 times 5 squared minus 4 times 1 squared. So solving for delta M, it is equal to 11.096 over EI kilonewton meter cube, the numerator. Substitute values. So 11.096 over E 10,000 megapascals or newton per mm square, 20 times 10 to the 6. So we multiply further by 1,000 to the 4th so that 11.096 kilonewton meter cube will become newton mm cube, so that delta m will be in mm. Solving for delta m, or the deflection at mid-span, it is 55.48 mm, and remember it is downward or negative. So compute the value of EI delta at the overhanging end of the beam A. So we first consider BCD, and the effect would be due to this loading and a moment here due to this loading at the overhang. So let's draw the figure for our guide. Then we have a moment here which is counterclockwise, equal to 200 times 3 times 1.5. So that would be 900 newton meter in that direction. Then, this is the deflected shape expected due to this overhang. That's the tangent. Then, this is theta B. This is the portion of the elastic curve which I cut here. Then, this is the net theta B due to the effect of the couple at B and the 200 newton meter load, uniform load. So that's theta B. This is also theta B, angle between the tangent at B and the horizontal. And this is also theta B. So therefore, we have a right triangle here. The opposite here is equal to 3 meters times theta B, or 3 theta B. Then this one is the, I'll call that delta A1. So the total distance from A to this point here is the deflection at A, which is downward in the figure. Then, how do we solve for delta A1? So imagine we have a cantilever beam at B, that's also theta B. So cantilever beam with loaded with 200 newton per meter, and this will deflect by delta A1. The formula to this will not be anymore, we will not draw the guide anymore because you're required to memorize. It was W L to the fourth over 8 EI. W L to the fourth over 8 EI, that's the value of delta A1. So for this effect, we need the information for theta at A. Though this is point B, but with respect to this figure, it should be theta A that is expected, and it is negative slope. So we treat this as negative. And due to this couple, which is at the point where the couple acts, we need theta B, and it is positive because this couple will tend the elastic curve to be concave upward, like at concave downward, that's the figure, and we treat this as positive. It should be theta b at the point of application of the couple, and that is theta positive. So theta b therefore is mo 900, l is 6, that's 6 meters, divided by 3ei. Then due to this one, which is theta a, treated negative, because this is the deflected shape, if MO is acting in the opposite way, the deflected shape will look like that. That's why MOL over TEI is treated positive. And this is negative because the net slope is positive in the figure. So minus theta A, W, 200 newton per meter, A is 3, so 3 square over 24. Length 6, EI, quantity A, 3 minus 2 times L, 2 times 6, quantity square. So combining, theta B is equal to 787.5 over EI. Then let's solve for delta A1, which is you're required to remember the formula, W L to the 4th over 384 EI. Or W O L to the 4th over 8 EI. So 200 times 3 to the 4th, because this is 3 meters over 8 EI. And that is equal to 2025 over EI downward. So finally, we can compute delta A. It is 3 times theta B plus delta A1. Let's treat them positive, but the deflection is downward. So delta A is equal to quantity 3 times theta B, which is 787.5 over EI, plus delta A1, which is 2025 over EI, downward. Combining, we can now compute delta A. And it is equal to 4387.5 over EI newton meter cube downward. The cross-section of the rectangular beam is 50 mm wide. Determine the smallest height, h, if the midspan deflection is limited to 20 mm. Use modulus of plasticity of 10 gigapascals. So here is the given figure. So we only need a guide for a beam, simply supported beam loaded with a concentrated load for its midspan deflection. And the formula is PB over 48EI quantity 3L square minus 4B square if A is greater than B. So treat for 400 Newton, B is 1, A is 4. For the 600 newton, B is 2 and A is 3. That happens when you position at the back. And we're computing for the midspan deflection only, so it's applicable. So therefore, delta midspan is equal to 400 times B, which is 1 over 48 EI quantity 3 times 5 square, this one is 5, minus 4 times 1 square, plus 600 times 2 over 48 EI quantity 3 times 5 square minus 4 times 2 square. So combining, midspan deflection is equal to 6200 over 3 newton or 3 EI newton meter cube, the unit of the numerator, because the unit of the load is newtons and the rest would be in meter. So substitute 20 mm equals 6200 times 1000 cube to convert that to newton mm cube over 3e is 10,000 megapascals newton per mm square, then moment of inertia I is in mm to the fourth. Solving for I is 10.33 times 10 to the 6 mm to the fourth, and that is equated to 58 cube over 12. So 10.33 times 10 to the 6 equals 50 times h cube over 12. Solving for h is equal to 135.4 mm. The overhanging beam ABC carries the uniformly distributed load between its supports and the concentrated load P at its end. Find the value of P for which there is no deflection at C. So here is the given beam. And this should be the expected elastic curve so that there will be no deflection at C. So we have a uniformly distributed load across the entire supports. and we have a couple here so that we can compute the net effect or slope at B. And second, we have a cantilever beam loaded with B. So for the first part, we have 200 kilonewton per meter, 1.8 meters span. Then we have a moment here, which is P times 0.6. So call that theta B. This is also theta B, the slope or the angle that the tangent at B makes with the horizontal. So that's net. And this is the portion of the elastic curve between A and B, which is cut here. So this is, we have a right triangle, so this is 0.6 times theta B, and that should be the equated to the deflection due to the cantilever beam loaded with a load P at the end. So that should be equal to delta C sub 1. So this is the couple, 0.6 P. The effect of the 2 kilonewton load will cause the slope to be up to the right. And that is treated positive. The effect of this couple, 0.6 P, would be to cause the elastic curve to rotate clockwise. So this is treated negative. And let's have a guide. That's also theta B. Then this is the other end loaded with B. The deflected shape would be equal to delta C sub 1. So that's why 0.6 theta B should be equal to delta C1, or 0.6 theta B minus delta C1 should be equal to 0. So that's the analysis. So we have to have this guide, although theta A equals theta B equals WO L cube over 24 EI, if you can remember. But you can have that as your guide. Then due to this couple, at the point of application, it was MOL over 3 EI, theta B. So that's it. So we treat theta B positive due to this uniform load, because this will be the deflected shape. It is inclined up. Then the effect of the couple is to concave down, and so it is rotating clockwise. So we treat theta B WL cube over 24 EI due to this uniform load positive, and due to this couple negative, MOL over TEI. So theta B is WO, which is 2 times L cube 1.8 cube over 24 EI, then minus MO, which is 0.6 P, L, which is 1.8 over 3 EI. Simplifying and treating EI as 1, because it is constant, for simplicity, 0.486 minus 0.36 P. Then for delta C1, remember the formula for the deflection is PL cube over 3 EI. So you should familiar with that formula. Not all the time you have to look at the guide or the table. So you have to familiar with that. If you derive that by so many methods, then you can easily remember that. So substitute P, L is 0.6 cube over 3 EI, which is treated as 1. So it is equal to 0.072 P. So equating 0.6 of theta B with delta C1, 0.6 of 0.486 minus 0.36 P equals 0.072 P. Or you may write that then minus 0.072 P equals 0. That's the other way. Divide everything by 0.6. So 0.486 minus 0.36 P equals 0.12 P. So from here we can solve for P, 0.486 divided by quantity, 0.36 plus 0.12, or 0.486 divided by 0.48, so P is equal to 1.012 kilonewtons. The trapezoidal loading is carried by the simply supported beam AB. The beam is a steel tube with the cross-section shown. Determine the displacement of the beam at mid-span and the slope angle of the elastic curve at end A. Use modulus of elasticity of 200 gigapascals for steel. So here is the given figure. So let's divide it into two parts. So remember that the midspan deflection is for the uniformly distributed load is 5WOL to the 4th over T84EI, but for the triangular load, it was 0.00615 something. So we need a table for that later. For the first part, theta A equals theta B WOL cube over 24EI, but let's confirm it later. But for the second, we need the table also. So this is also 15 after we divide the loading into trapezoidal loading into rectangular and triangular. So both WO would be 15. So this is the guide. Theta A equals theta B equals WL cube over 24EI. For the deflection, 5WOL to the 4th over 24EI. So there's no need to put it. So this is the center deflection, 0.00651 WOL to the 4th over EI. Theta A, 7WOL cube over 360EI. Theta B, WL cube over 48EI. But although this is point A, the load, the intensity of the load is concentrated at A, so it should be theta B that must be used because it's like this one. Theta B WOL cube over 45 EI. First, for the midspan deflection. So delta at midspan is equal to 5WOL to the 4th over 384 EI plus 0.00651 WOL to the 4th over EI. Substitute 5 times 15 times 3 to the 4th over 384 EI plus 0.00651015 3 to the 4th over EI. Combining, the midspan deflection is equal to 23.73 kilonewton meter cube over EI. Downward. So substitute values. Delta mid 23.73 times 1000 to the 4th to convert that to Newton mm cube over E, which is 200,000 megapascals Newton per mm square, times I, which is pi over 4 quantity outer radius 80 to the 4th minus inner radius 70 to the 4th mm to the 4th. So the unit of midspan deflection is mm, obviously. So the midspan deflection is equal to 8.913 mm downward. For theta A, it is WOL cube over 24EI plus, because this is A by our guide here, so it is theta B that is used. So theta A is equal to WO L cube over 24EI plus WO L cube over 45EI. So theta A is equal to 15 times 3 to the 3rd over 24EI plus 15 times 3 to the 3rd over 45EI. Clockwise. So theta A is equal to 25.875 kilonewton meter square because we are just computing the slope over EI. So theta A is equal to 25.875 times 1000 cube only to convert that to Newton meter mm square. E is 200,000 Newton per mm square. Then moment of inertia pi over 4 quantity 80 to the 4th minus 70 to the 4th mm to the 4th. So the units of the denominator is the same as that of the numerator. So theta A would be in radians or unitless. But let's convert that to degrees by multiplying 180 degrees over pi. So in degrees, 0.5568 degrees. Clockwise, in particular. So next, determine the maximum value of EI delta for the cantilever beam that carries the triangular loading shown in the figure. So here is the given figure and there's no guide for this loading. So we have to compute for the equivalent force acting at B and the couple at B. And we'll now have a guide for that. Then in the second part, let's chop B. Then we have a cantilever end loaded with this triangular load. there's no, again, guide for that loading, so we make it rectangular, then we add an equivalent upward load, which is triangular, so that we'll have a guide for that case. So this is now the equivalent beam, composite beams. 1/2 of 3 × 600 is 900 newtons downward, and the moment is 1/2 of 3 × 600, 900 times moment arm 2, so 1000. There is also a couple here of 1800 newton meter. Then this is the deflected shape. We have tangent, net tangent due to the combined effects of the concentrated load and the couple. So that's theta B. We draw horizontal line through the end of the elastic curve. This is also theta B. So therefore, I'll call this delta B. Delta B is the combined effect of the concentrated load at the free end of the cantilever beam and this couple here, which are both downward effects. And due to this right triangle, this is 3 times theta B because the length is 3. Then we have the deflected shape of the entire beam. So that's the tangent at B due to the two loads. So this is delta B. That's theta B. So delta B, which is this, and 3 times theta B. And therefore, this remaining part is due to the cantilever beam loaded with triangular loading, which we will modify so that we can have our guide. So this is delta C1. I'll call that delta C1. For delta C1, let's have this cantilever beam here. So this total deflection is the maximum deflection at the free end. I'll call that delta C. So this is the cantilever beam loaded with this triangular load, but there's no guide for that. So let's make it uniform, 600 newton per meter, and we have a counter upward triangular load, 600 at B, newton per meter at B. So that's, they are equivalent now. So for delta B, so this is delta C1. So although I can memorize for the deflection PL cube over 3EI, then theta at B is PL square over 2EI. But in your case, you can have that. The rest for couple, deflection is MO L square over 2EI. Then theta B is MO L over EI. Then the rest I can memorize, especially for the uniform load of the cantilever beam and this triangular load. For the deflection, WOL to the 4/8EI for the uniform load. For triangular load, WOL to the 4/30EI. So delta B is equal to PL cube over 3EI plus MOL square over 2EI due to this couple. Substitute 900 times 3 cube over 3EI, this is 3, plus 1800 times 3 square over 2EI. Combining, delta B is 16200 over EI. Then theta B, PL square over 2EI. So 900 times 3 square over 2EI plus MOL over EI. So 1800 times 3 over EI. Both will contribute to theta B. So that's why they are treated positive. But theta B is supposedly negative because the rotation is clockwise. Let's just have that way. So theta B is equal to 9450 over EI. Then delta C1, let's make the deflection due to the uniform load positive, due to the upward load negative, because the net deflection is downward. So it is equal to WO L to the 4th over 8EI, then minus WO L to the 4th over 30EI. Or if in your case, if you can't memorize, consult the table. Substitute, so 600 times 3 to the 4th over 8EI minus 600 times 3 to the 4th over 30EI. And that is equal to 4455 over EI. So finally, the maximum deflection, which is delta C, EI delta C, can now be computed. So delta C is 16,200 over EI plus 3 times 9450 over EI plus 4455 over EI. So delta C is equal to, EI delta C is equal to 49,005 Newton meter cube downward. So that's it for this problem. Find the vertical displacement of point C of the frame ABC. The cross-sectional moments of inertia are 2IO for segment AB and IO for segment BC. So first, let's have transmit for member AB the couple, which is WOA A over 2, so WO A square over 2. So that's the guide. And we can compute, that's the deflected shape, we can compute theta B. Then connect BC, then the angle that this BC makes with horizontal is theta B also, so that's why this vertical deflection due to the slope theta B is A theta B, because that length is A. Then for the entire beam, because we have a cantilever, we treat this as cantilever beam, and it will deflect farther downward by delta C1, even by WL, where L is A to the 4th over 8EI. So that's the case. Then this is A theta B, and this is delta C1. And the entire vertical deflection is delta C sub V. Then, for the cantilever effect, it will deflect by delta C1, whose formula is known, WO L to the 4th over 8EI, where L is A in this case, and I is IO. Here, I is 2IO. So that's for this case, the deflection is MOL square over 2EI, but we need only theta B for that case, because we are computing for the vertical deflection. So MOL over EI for theta B. So theta B is MOWO A square over 2 times L, which is 2A, divided by E, then the moment of inertia is 2IO. Simplifying, cancel 2, so WO A cube, theta B is WO E cube over 2 EIO. Then delta C1 is equal to WO A to the 4th over 8 EIO. So therefore, the vertical deflection at C can now be computed. It is equal to A times theta B, WO A cube over 2 EIO, plus WO A to the 4th over 8 EIO. So the vertical deflection at C can now be computed. It is 5 WO A to the 4th over 8 EIO downward. So that's it for this last problem.